is Joe with Joe Lee Farms in Ecuador. Welcome back to the channel. We're here at our homestead today and want to apologize. We haven't been producing that many videos lately because I've been a little bit under the weather, both figuratively and literally. The weather right now, you know, for the last couple of weeks has just been gloomy like it is today and very, very windy. And I just hate producing videos in this kind of wind. So, you know, we've been holding off and the weather here will change. We are in the dry, windy season. And, you know, we'll have days where it's just windy for days on end. And then we get a week of really nice weather. So we'll wait for that to change. We'll produce a lot more videos when that happens. But I wanted to talk to you today about a subject we've touched on a little bit in other videos, but not a lot. Workmanship in Ecuador, or quality craftsmanship, whatever you like to call it or refer to it as, is fine. Can you get quality workmanship or quality craftsmanship here in Ecuador? Well, the answer is yes and no. So not to be wishy-washy, but yeah, we have found some really good instances of really good quality craftsmanship. Leather goods here in Ecuador, oh wow, there are some great leather craftsmen. You know, I bought leather belts over in Cuenca for $10 a piece that, you know, I wore one about a year and the buckle broke because it wasn't a very good buckle. But the leather quality was wonderful. I bought a leather belt in Cuenca, in Loja the other day. It was twice as much. It was $20. But the buckle was done all in leather. Man, they just did a really nice job on it. So yeah, leather goods, man, all over Loja, all over Ecuador. And there are certain villages here in Ecuador that are known for their leather goods, and you can research that. There are other villages that are known for their basket weaving and different types of blankets and things like that, more in the northern part of Ecuador. So yeah, there's lots of great stuff like that. I've been absolutely blown away by some of the artists' work here. Extremely talented artists, extremely talented people in general. When it comes to construction and things like that, there are some things that I would hope will improve over time. You have to understand the accessibility to construction products that we have in North America aren't necessarily available here. A lot of those things are becoming available. Some of the technologies, dogs come to visit. Hey, what are you doing? Some of the technology has, you know, finally coming down here. And so we're seeing some improvement there. We've had some great people working on our property and we've had some not so great people. And it's just kind of luck of the draw. You got to do a little bit of research. I'll give you a prime example. Our woodworker that we access through our architect, Milton Mina, our woodworker's name is Augusto. And shout out to Augusto. Man, this guy does some quality woodwork. He won't stop till he's, you know, absolutely happy with the way it's turned out. We had a situation where we had some cabinets put in a little cubby hole in the kitchen, and it was out of square to start with, and so it's all done in cement, in concrete, so he couldn't really change that. But he went in and made a cabinet, and he worked on it for 2 hours till he got it to look as good as it possibly could. Way acceptable to us. I imagine if you're a real stickler, you know, you might have an issue with it, but man, it looks great. Nobody would notice it if I didn't point it out. Augusto made cabinets for our bathroom. He made cabinets for our kitchen. I'm putting up pictures here so you can see that. And he just does great, great quality work. And he really, you know, pays attention to the detail. So our tile guys, we've had some great tile guys on the property. Again, some access to Milton Mina and his workers, and remodeled our bathroom. And, you know, the picture of the tile here, there's a couple things I really want to point out. We had to search high and low for the exact tile we wanted. But I really was after the tile layer. Hey, I really want this shower to slope downwards here where the drain is, because they have a habit here of putting the drain in the highest spot in the floor for some reason. We see that in our house currently, and we've seen it in other houses. So he really, I mean, painstakingly overemphasized the slope and made it all just like I wanted it, really. And then the ledge in the shower, I said I really want it to slope in toward the shower and not in toward the window. And so he was very careful to make that pretty dramatic as well, so that the water wouldn't settle up there, it would run off. And so, you know, these are quality craftsmen here that pay attention to what the customer's requests are, and they ask, you know, before they're done, if you like everything and you need to change anything. So these are really good quality craftsmen. As you can see, there's a lot of stonework here that takes place, and man, the stonemasons are really remarkable how well they do. We have a stonemason, concrete worker guy, what we call a maestro. We're going to introduce you to in another video. And a good friend of mine works for me a lot, because we do little projects here. And so we'll introduce you to he and probably his whole family. You've already met his sister, that's one hint. So yeah, lots of great you know, stonework masons. We've had, you know, a few issues where we've had to tell people, yeah, that's not at all what we wanted. And it's been a challenge. You know, we bought a refrigerator we're struggling with right now. We'll see if we actually get that new refrigerator to function properly and if that actually works out. So we'll let you know on that. That may be a whole video in itself. So today I want to show you, you've seen before in our water video, of what we've done to bring in a filtration system, extra water storage, and we also put our Italian pump on it. And the guys who installed this, you know, not to mention any names, but it was an interesting job. I, for the life of me, I'm not sure why they did it the way they did it. I can see some reasoning in it. But I went to change my water filters, and where they connected all this was constantly leaking. And I would call them and they would come out and they'd say, oh, too much pressure. And so we've never had a problem with pressure on this property before. The unions, you know, aren't meant to hold that much pressure. And so I finally gave up on them. And I went one day to change the filters and to fix these unions and put new unions on, because I could see they were stripped. And I wound up with a terrible surprise, and I'll show you. I'm actually going to wind up having to redo this entire thing at some point in the future. But I'm going to stop here, take you over, and show you the filters and what's going on with this. Okay, so our water storage tanks are right outside the wall here. The water comes in on this 1-inch pipe, goes down, and they put in finally came back and put in a pressure reducer because they said it's just too much pressure. Well, it's not too much pressure. Now, this is an adjustable reducer, so I could bring it up now if I wanted to. Put a gauge on it, which, you know, proves there's not much pressure. So it comes in here, they put a union right here so they could, what we might call a slip fitting. And so it comes over here and we've got three filters in line, the filter manifolds and the unions right here that they put in, they call them uniones here actually. These were crooked on here before on both of these. So I had to come back in, take this all apart, and I had to, dogs, get out of here, dogs. And so I had to come in here and replace these unions. Now, since I put that back together, we've had zero leaks. It works fine. But I'm going to show you what I found when I went to take apart these manifolds. They have four screws on top holding them to this bracket. The screws are completely stripped inside the manifold. The manifold part is stripped. These screws are in there crooked. And the reason is because these plates sit on this wall and they're crooked. They put these in with some anchors, and this whole thing is cattywampus. Each one of these is a little different height, a little different cock to it. And so then they went to put these in and they had to cross thread them to get them in there. It took me an hour to get these four screws out of this first one. And so two of them will not line up and won't go back in. They're completely stripped out. So this is a problem. What should really happen here is there should be a plate behind here on this wall, and then these things should be mounted to that plate where it's nice and flush. So redoing that would be a little bit of a challenge, but it can happen. It would have been easy if we'd done it when the whole project first started. Now, I'm afraid to take the rest of these screws out down here because I'm afraid that all of these housings are going to be the same way. at least this first housing is going to have to be replaced at the tune of about $120. So it's not cheap to redo this. This is a pretty serious flaw in workmanship right here. And again, these screws are never going to go back in these holes, and they're stripped, and it's just a really, really poor job. They did some good work in other places here. They really fell apart right here. Now, my unions, because they didn't put these screws back in here, it allowed the unions to line up nice and straight so they threaded properly. The way this was all cross-threaded was constantly putting pressure on this joint, because if you got two pipes trying to line up and one of them's, you know, always got pressure on it this way, it's always going to cause a problem. There's just a small little round rubber O-ring inside of there with very little surface area that has to match up to keep it from leaking. So the slightest bit of torsion on it and it's going to create a leak on that little O-ring. Okay, well, I want to show you the next thing they did that I wasn't real happy with, and we'll go outside the gate. Okay, so here we are out at two of our storage tanks right outside the wall, and you can see this conglomeration of mess going on here. What they had coming in here originally was a piece of SpaFlex, or flexible pipe, coming in and jammed into the fittings here. And so SpaFlex is okay, but quite frankly, there's no need for it. So it didn't last 24 hours. It blew apart, ran out all the water everywhere. So we had them come back and they glued it again, left. Well, it didn't last for 2 hours. So I kind of gave up on them. And I got, they were using a thin body glue, PVC glue. I came back with some of what we used to call hot glue. This is a medium body glue that actually heats and helps weld the pipe together. I also put in solid pipe, and then I actually went and took this strap and strapped it all together while it dried. And I left it overnight with no water. And since we've had zero leaks, zero problems with this. I do have a little leak going on here on one of the valves that they installed, kind of so-so. I'll have to come back and fix that as well. So one of the things here in Ecuador is they use a lot of threaded pipe for plumbing, and they don't use hardly any glue-on fittings. So their experience with thin and medium body glues probably is not that much. So I've done a lot of gluing with PVC. And I understand, you know, larger the pipe, more likely the hydraulic pressure is to push it apart before it dries. And so having these things strapped together or held together while it dries really helps. I've glued a lot of pipe, and I know in high pressure situations, you got to have a little bit better glue. You got to have it primed. They don't seem to know what primer is here. So you've got to prime your pipe and then put the glue on, and then it usually works very well. Okay, so here we are still at our tanks, and you can see the water comes in here. Tanks fill up. They have a float valve in them, shuts off when they're empty. And they also have a valve in them at the bottom, so when they run out of water, it shuts the pump off inside so that it doesn't burn the pump out. Great idea. Glad they did that. Everyone should do that. That's kind of a pretty standard thing to do. So I want to say that, you know, I'm being critical because I have to keep coming back and fixing this myself. This is not about pressure. This is about just not doing the job correctly. And while I love these guys, they're great guys and everything, they just didn't do the job that well. And I think it could have been done better. And had my Spanish been a little better, I would have sat right there and corrected them every step of the way. It would have drove them nuts. But I've done this enough that I know that they should take some precautions and do things, you know, a little bit more than what's required, and then you don't have to come back. Now, the last time they came back, you know, they charged me. Well, you know, personally, I think that ought to be under warranty. But it is what it is. So, yeah, you're going to run into some of this kind of thing here in Ecuador. And the clearer you can be with your instructions or have a translator who's very, very clear with them, and help them understand that you're going to withhold some money and you're not going to pay them that money until they do it like you want it. So, you know, there's ins and outs of that we could discuss. But I think that, you know, that's really important to get that across. if you have a really firm understanding up front or a contract, a lot of them have contracts, and I think if it's in the contract and that's the way you want it, then they have to make it that way legally. So I do think there's quality craftsmanship here. There's quality workmanship here. There's great workers. If you look at the walls on the outside of our to go all the way around our property here, this brickwork is absolutely perfectly straight. This is some of the best brickwork you'll find. Now, I've seen a lot of brickwork in the U.S. that didn't look as good as this. We didn't do this. The gentleman before us that owned the property did this. And I know the young man that worked for him that was in charge of the project, and he said he would come out every day and look at it. If a brick wasn't quite right, he'd say, tear it all down, start over. So he got the workers to understand what he wanted and how he wanted it, and they did a marvelous job on this. This is going to be here till long after I'm gone. Great workmanship on the bricks. There's just a lot of things here you're going to find extremely good workmanship on. Mechanics are just like mechanics in North America. They're going to be good and bad. You're going to have your car worked on. You're going to find somebody eventually that you really like. You have to go through some bad ones first. So, yeah, it's just like anywhere else when that's as far as that's concerned. I think, you know, maybe because we're here in the country, there's a little bit different labor pool. I don't know. That's debatable. But I think that the clearer you can be on your expectations and showing them pictures and drawings and outlining it exactly, and please do everything in centimeters. If you tell them inches, you know, then they try to go convert it. But if you do it in centimeters, then you know exactly what to expect, and they do too. So expectations, going to have to manage them. Some places you're going to have to compromise, and then some places you're going to have to stick to your guns and demand it be done properly, but in a nice way. All right, hope this video helps. Hope it offers some insight to what it's like to live in Ecuador. Thumbs up. Have a great day.